Good evening to all of you. And in this session of Java lecture, I'm going to discuss about the collection framework that is provided by the Java Utility Library. And there is a huge number of huge collection of classes and interfaces for various operation. And we'll see some of the examples. Some of the classes we'll pick up and see their functionalities. Okay. And using that, I think it will be once you know some of them. So other classes or interfaces operations are almost similar, okay, to the examples that we're going to discuss. So this will help you to learn about other collection classes or interfaces that will be left you as an exercise. So to begin with, the Java utility collection framework supports a wide range of classes and interfaces for broad range. So there is no specific set of functionality. So they support all, you know, almost all type of functionality that we generally perform during our developing a software. Okay. So we'll focus on the storage structures, data structures, which are really essential. That is array list, map, hash map, and an iterator. Okay. So I'm discussing only these four concepts, okay, which are really essential. Others, once you learn about this, others are very similar to this. So the functionalities you will find, like, you know, we'll also, because I have skipped the interfaces of the classes, like, you know, array, simply array, or list, or vector. Okay, so as I assume that as a reader, you people are already acquainted with this kind of the containers. Okay, that you have already seen in C++. So the things which are little different and with these examples, I'm going to explain how we can use a collection frame, collection class in Java. Okay, so my list of collection classes are array list, map, hash map, and iterator. About an iterator, how we can utilize an iterator to iterate over a collection. So begin with the array list class. So array list class extend the abstract list, okay, class, okay, which is the parent class of this array list, and it implement list interface. So array, there are interfaces. Okay, we have interface. There is a lot of collection interfaces. I would suggest you to go to pick up any book like Java Complete Reference. There you will find the entire list of the interfaces and the classes supported by the Java Utility Collection. Okay, so array list is a generic class. Okay, just like you can think of a template class. Okay, so which can be created for any type of object that we need. Okay, remember, not any type, when I tell any type, that does not include the primitive type. All right, so it can be created for any specific type of object. Okay, so object of type, in the previous lecture we have seen that type, the mostly we'll see that for utilizing the basic type, like an integer value or double value, we need an object here. That's why we discussed about the type wrapper. So type wrapper classes are now here will be helpful to create objects, okay, to be part of this generic classes. All right, so they are templates. They can take an object of any, you know, type of any type of object that we mention. Okay, and the main objective behind array list is that it supports a dynamic array. Okay, normal array that we have seen so far, or you refer the array class, of that size is fixed. Okay, whatever size you allocate, that data will be allocated within that that size only. All right, but here in array list is little dynamic. So whenever the size exceeds the given size, it automatically enlarges and occupy the data. All right. So whenever you are allocating some element to the object of this class, so and where the values may be increasing more than size, it automatically enlarge. So there won't be any error, okay, any indexing error problem here. Okay, and when objects are removed, automatically array shrinks. Okay, so that's why it's a common, the name came for it, is a feature of, it has the feature of array, okay, accessing the element by index. All right, and at the same time it can shrink and expand dynamically. That's why the name came ArrayList class. Let's see an example of ArrayList here. Okay, it will be more clear to understand. So let us begin with the creating, okay, an ArrayList object. So we are, it's a generic, as I told, it's a generic class. So whenever it's a generic class, we have to pass the type whenever you are creating an object of a generic class. Very similar to the STL library or the template, STL standard template library you might have studied in C++. So the name of the class here, ArrayList, then we pass the type here within the less than and greater than symbol to indicate what type of, okay, what is the type of element that this ArrayList object will hold. Okay, so AL is the name of the object, okay, which is created. So new ArrayList string, okay, an empty string. So initially it is an array, empty ArrayList is created, okay, and if you print here and the built-in method size is supported for ArrayList. So this not only for ArrayList, many other classes where the elements are stored, okay, I would say, which is generic class type, the size method is also supported for showing the size, the current size of the object, okay, of the particular collection class type. All right. So when I print al.size, it will show me the current, how many elements are currently there. So what is the element type here? String. So each element that I will store in my this ArrayList will be of type string here. So I can change it. I can store integer type. I can store double type. So depend upon. So this is the, because it's a generic class, I can create any type of object. Okay, I can create an object to store any type of element right here. So I have chosen string here. All right. So then using the method add. So there are two methods: add and remove. The object dot method add. Object dot remove, both will, so the it is also overloaded, so we can use that. So to add an element, so string, see that, because I want to add an element here, my element is of type string, so I will pass a string type here. So see that, we know that we can pass string literal, and string class can automatically, type conversion can be done to a string type objects. Okay, so this string literal will become a string object and will be added to the ArrayList. Okay, so first C is added, then A is added. Okay, so whenever we are adding like this, all the elements will be added to at the end of the ArrayList, the current ArrayList. Okay, so C will be the first element, then A, then E, B, D, F. Now we can also add by index. So this, there is a two parameter here. You can see that. Okay, so first parameter has to be the index. Okay, so at the index position 1, so add the element A2. So now whatever it was there, that will be shifted one place towards the right, and A2 will be inserted in the position 1. So that also can be done. Not only always adding, add not only will add at the end. Suppose you are not providing index, by default it will add at the end. All right. So this is the flexibility you can use with add. All right. So we have added 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 elements. So when you print here, the size will be changed. Now AL size will print at 7. All right. Then we can print the content. So to print the content, we can simply print the object. As we know already, I've told you that every class like this, okay, when it is used as a concatenated with a string, they output automatically. So because it's a library class, so they automatically call the value and they invoke the value, okay, the value method, okay, and which in turn call toString, if you remember. Okay, so toString method might have been already been implemented in the class ArrayList, so which will, okay, print in the desired format the way the toString has been implemented over there. Okay, so here there will be a call to toString method for the object AL, remember that. So it will print the content of the ArrayList, the desired format that has been designed to print the print an ArrayList. Okay, so for every ArrayList or a list or a vector, definitely whenever we are printing, we are printing the object, the toString method, okay, which is implemented or overridden within that, okay, so that is going to be invoked. So it will print here, we'll see that it will print exactly in the array format, okay, in the array format. All right, then using remove, we are removing by element name. Look at that here. okay, remove the by element name. Also we can remove by the index value. All right, but remember one thing, that when the elements are here string, that's why we can do in both the modes or any other type. But when the elements are exactly integer, because index are integer format, then in that case we cannot remove the element by index, by element. There only removal will be done by index. Whenever you pass an integer, it automatically assumes that we are removing the element by index, not by a value, okay, even if the elements are of integer type. All right, so this is the point here. So like, so we can use remove method to remove the element. So automatically whenever the element is removed, the size of the array list is shrinked. Okay, it is now, it is 7. So that is mean that if number of the element at the position 2, that is e, is removed, but that doesn't make that the arrays will be size will be fixed, automatically shrinks. Okay, the size will become 5. So when you print here in this line, the size is going to be 5. So that makes it array list attractive, okay, to use a dynamic array. Okay, dynamic array is whenever we need, and for any type of object. It's not that only every time we create an array we have to fix the size. Here size is not fixed, so you need it, whatever you know, object type you want to store it, create it. You are here, the it is string. You can create your own user defined object. You can pass here, suppose box, we have created a box if you remember, so we can pass a box here, we can pass an employee here. So a list of array list of employee, array list of boxes, okay, array list of lines, okay. So any, it can support both the predefined objects as well as user defined object. So it's up to you how you depend. Yeah, some cases what may happen, you have to override some of the method. Okay, you have to make sure that for some operation which cannot be performed by default, you have to override that method for the user defined objects. That's it. So in your class, okay. So let us run this example and see a simple example. Array list demo. Okay. So array list. So sorry, just to demo array list demo. So initial size of array list is 0. Then we added by using 7 element, we added, so you see that we have inserted a2 by index, using index, okay, in the add method. So you see that a2 is inserted exactly in the position 1. So this way, then we removed the element f, so f is deleted from here. Then from at the position 2, I think, right? Yes, in from the position 2, so from the position 2 means a. So A and F are deleted. So once A and F are removed, the resulting list is this, and the number of element is 5. So it can grow and shrink, okay, dynamically. That is the benefit of using array list. All right, and remember that we can never assign an element of primitive type. You can remember, you cannot create an array list, not only array list, any other collection class of primitive data type. Never try to ever to do that, okay, then you will get an error. Okay, I'll show you a demo with that. Okay, so I have another example here. All right, which will demonstrate a numeric one. Okay, so here is the one, okay, numeric one. So here is an integer, so what I will try here, see that, okay, I'll try to integer, give the primitive type. Okay, I'm creating array list of a primitive type. Okay, so what is the problem? Let us see that. Okay, what the error we will get. Definitely we are going to get an error because it's not supported by a primitive type. We have that's why the class type wrappers has been defined. So array list numeric demo. Okay, so you can see that the error is giving that create a required a reference found int. Okay, so it is expecting some an object. Okay, so unexpected type. So it's saying that int is not the type which is accepted here. Okay, it is, we are expecting an object. So that's why we can use the type wrapper class. Okay, we know already learned that. Okay, so we can use the type wrapper class integer. Okay, so integer array list. I'm going to create integer list. And you see that I'm adding the element 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and also at one position, the same thing, I'm inserting 7. So after run this, okay, I'm going to print 1, 2, 3, 1. 17 17 23 4 5 6, that will be the error, right? And what happens here, then I remove 2, Okay, so here remove 2 and 3 does not indicate remove the element 2 or remove the element 3. So whenever you pass an integer to the remove method, so it automatically invoke the overloaded remove method, which is deleting element by index, not by value. We'll verify that. Okay, so let us run it and verify how it is deleting and how we are creating an integer wrapper class object, okay, for the array list. So now let us we have already modified. Let us run it again. Array list numeric type remove demo. Okay, fine. Now let us run it. So initial size 0, then we added 7 elements. So you can see that first 7 is added in the first index, so rest 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, this is the array array list created. Then we have removed 2 elements, one is 2 and 3. You see that 3 is present. Okay, so 2 is because 2 is present in the index index 2, that's why it is there. So what is the element present in the index 2? First of all, 2. What is the element present in the index 3? In index 3, the 4. Okay, so you see that. So when 2 is deleted, the 3 becomes the index 1 at index 0 1 2 2. Okay, and 4 becomes the index 2. That's why when we removed, sorry, 4 becomes the index 3. Sorry for that. Okay, so when 2 is deleted, okay, 3 takes its position, right? Then so 3 becomes the at the index 2, and 4 becomes at the index 3. That's why when we delete by 3, okay, when we perform this, the 4 is deleted. Okay, so it is very clear to see that, clear that it is not removing by value. Whenever you pass integer type, then it's not removing by value, rather by index. Okay, this sort removal happens by index. That is to be very clear. All right, so that's why the position, the index from here in this array element at the index 2 is deleted. Then after the updated array list, the element which is present at the index 3 is deleted, and this is the resulting array list. Okay, so this is how we can use the array list. Next, some other methods which are defined for array list. That is, we can now we have discussed that the size can increase and shrink dynamically, but still suppose you want to ensure the confirm a size, okay, you want to increase the size manually, then we can use the method. There is also a method to fix the size, you know, to improve the size manually. I want to confirm, I want to ensure that, okay, this much size is there, okay, without any problem. So ensure capacity method, you pass the capacity as an integer value to, okay, ensure that new capacity, so whatever size is, if you give this, it will be, generally we give the size larger than the current one, okay, to ensure the capacity. So that the now the capacity will increase to that size, okay. And the conversely, we can also reduce the size of the array that underlines an array list object, so that it is precisely as large as the number of items. So what happens, there might be we have increased it, maybe we might have, might have some space, but that doesn't happen generally, okay, if you do your remove mechanism, some other way it might happen. So when you call trim to size, it will exactly sync the array list to the exactly size of the number of elements present in the, so there won't be any extra space, okay. So maybe by ensure capacity, you might have added some extra element, that all will be shrinked. Okay, so trim to size is the converse operation of the ensure capacity, you can say. Then we can also convert them an array list into an array object. Okay, array is an object type. Okay, so to convert into an array object type, we can do that. Okay, we can also, so there is two array method. Okay, you call with the object. Okay, with the object to array, or we pass the array list object as a parameter to the two array, all right, and to a particular type object, you can see that it's a T indicate the type, okay, of the array. So this is the array type, this T and T name is the array type, and we call with the two array by passing the array list here. Yeah, this is the, you will be array list here. Okay, we'll see an example more clever. Okay, so we have an array list here, okay, of integer type. We have added 1 2 3 4 to this, all right. So array a list containing 3-4 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we create an array of object of integer wrapper, okay, integer type wrapper. All right, so integer array size, exactly size, its size is equal to the size of the array list of the integer type we have created. So it is a generic array list of integer type, but it is an array of integer object type. So you should be very clearly should be able to distinguish it. Okay, so it is an array of integer type wrapper object type. Here it is an array list of type integer elements. Okay, so both are storing the same type of element, that must be clear. So but here it is an array, it is an array list, right? It's a simple array. You know how to create an array in Java. Okay, now we can use the method. Now you want to convert this array list into an array, okay, of the desired type. So since array list is an integer type, we can convert this into an array, a normal array of integer class type. So that can be done by two arrays. So you can see that AL, we use the reference of AL. Okay, AL is the the array list object. So object dot two array, all right, and we pass the array type here. Okay, here the first one is to pass the array type here. What array type we have to pass it. So and it returns the IA. Okay, that same array it returns it. Okay, so both we have to give here and here. All right. So what happens? All the elements of AL are now converted into array. So all the elements are now stored in the object that we pass here. So it was written here IA. Okay. So reference is given here. All right. So now all the elements here now stored in the integer class integer object array. All right. IA. Then we can print this IA. So we can, you are using an for each loop here, integer I colon IA sum. So we calculating sum here. So simply we add them all the values. First I 1, 2, 3, 4. So it should be sum should be 10. Okay. So this is how we can convert using two array. Okay, and two array and object of array list type. Okay, the element of array list object type to an array type, to an array of any type object. Let's see the example. So Java array list, array list to array, list to array. Okay, so this is the content of the array list 1, 2, 3, 4, then converted into integer type array, integer class type array. Then we using that we calculate the sum. Okay, using the for each loop. Okay, so you can see that this is how we can use. This is a demonstration of two array method. Okay, two array method for array list class. Next, the iterator. Okay, we have already, people who have already studied about C++, they already know about iterator. So generally, iterator is an object that implements either the iterator or list iterator interface in the Java. Okay, in Java, either could be possible. All right, list iterator interface you can be used to create an iterator object or iterator class itself. Okay, so it enables you. You know that an iterator enables us to cycle through a collection and obtaining or removing the element. So till now we have seen that iterator can only iterate and access the value. But here we have an iterator type that is called list iterator, can also not only can cycle through and access the value, but also we can access in a bidirectional. So the first feature is that we can access the element in bidirectional way. Normal iterator only go in one unidirectional, from the first position to the last position. But list iterator not only can move from first position to the last position, but also can in a reverse traverse from the last position towards the first position. And in addition to that, it can modify an element. We can update an element through an iterator. Okay, so given in a class of elements, using an iterator, okay, referring to the particular class of element, we can also modify the elements using this iterator. Okay, so iterator and list iterator generic interface is given like this. Okay, so we prove iterator, and here E is the type of the object that is been iterated. Okay, so depend upon the class type that you are going to iterate, you can mention like that. Okay, you must note one thing, that if you won't be modifying suppose you are not modifying the element, okay, because the essential part of the register address that it can modify it, okay, or it do reverse order, it can access the reverse order. So if you're not doing these things, better not to use list iterator. Better you can use for loops, you know, for each unidirectional we can access each the element. So to access only access in each element in one direction from first to the last, you do not use list iterator. Unless until you are not doing bidirectional traversal or you are not modifying element, it is recommended that you always use for each loop. Okay, only when you are doing these two operation you use the iterator of list iterator type. Okay, that's the idea. So you know, little bit, because this kind of iterator having more feature are little bit overhead. They have some little bit overhead. Okay, so if you're doing a simple operation, so it is not recommended to use a list iterator. Here is an example for that. So as usual, we have created an array list of string type and added some element 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Fine. Okay. So and we have created an iterator, simple iterator. We have two type, list iterator, and so iterator can do the simple thing. Okay, it can move in one direction only. And the method has next will verify whether there is a next element present or not. Okay, true or not. If it is true, then there is an element, next element is present. Okay, so it can access to the next element. So ITR is the iterator object. Okay, and it is referring to, okay, the it is an iterator of which object? The AL object. Okay, so AL dot iterator. So AL dot iterator will give a reference to ITR. Okay, so for AL, the iterator, okay, method will give a reference to ITR. Now ITR object of iterator type will act as an iterator for that. Okay, so iterator has next is true means next it can access the next element. So next method will access the next element. Will access and also return the next element of the class, okay, of the class or of the object, okay, of a given class. All right, so here you are printing the element. Okay, so this is a demonstration has next. Now list iterator an object created. Again we are al dot list iterator, we have to access this method. So iterator list iterator, so any class of this type, array list or array, or okay, they have the method to okay, whichever classes are iteratable, remember that not all the classes are iteratable. Okay, you cannot iterate through that. Whichever can be iterate, okay, for them these methods are given. Iterator methods are there, list iterator methods are there. So you can call list iterator method to give the reference to the object of list iterator type. Okay, now we using now litr we can access while litr has next. So as long as there is an element in the collection, okay, then we can process and we can use the same method, next method here. Okay, and to modify we can use the set method. So next element we're doing that now, litr dot set, okay, we do the element plus a plus. Okay, so we are setting the current, whatever the current object, current element it is pointing to, that element will be modified. Okay, so we are accessing the current element now using the next. Okay, and we are modifying this by using n plus to it. So whatever the element is, so c plus a plus e, in this way we are adding a plus to it. You see that? Okay, using list iterator, that is the benefit. So this at the line set, okay, is one of the advantages of using list iterator. We can modify not only access, we can modify the element of an of a class, okay, of a collection class. Then we can print it. So we are iterating through a simple ITR, okay, to iterate again through the, so we are again assigning ITR equal to AI iterator to, so to point out the beginning, because it has accessed all the element at this point. So reset again, we'll use ITR equal to AL iterator, so that it will point, it will refer to the beginning of the collection. Then again we are iterating and printing the elements. Okay, either modified element that has been done by that modified by the list iterator. Also the last loop is showing that we can reverse back. Okay, so by the time we accessed this loop, the LITR is pointing to the last element. Okay, it has already pointed to the next end of the array list. Okay, so using has previous we can again refer back. So has previous, has next, there are two methods for checking whether there is a next element or a previous element, and next and previous both are supported by list iterator only. Iterate can access only next, remember that. So that is the benefit of using your list iterator. Okay, traversing in both direction as well as modifying an element. Let us run this and see this output. Alright, so originally we added C, A, E, B, D, F. Okay, then using the list iterator, we iterated this through using the iterator. You remember that, okay? So first one, first loop, okay, this one. We are printing this. You see that we are using print so that all the elements will be printed in the same line. Okay, so yes, the first let is printed. Then using list iterator, we are accessing as well as we are modifying it. Okay, we added a plus to all the elements. You have in the, okay, if you remember this part, okay, and here we see that we are adding the element set element, okay, all the elements. So it is printing C plus A plus E plus B plus D plus F plus. So now it is now the list iterator is pointing to the end. Then when using the backward, okay, we print F plus D plus previous. So this is accessed, this is printed using the previous method. This is printed by using the next method of the iterator. This is printed using the list iterator. So this is the benefit of using the list iterator, okay, compared to normal iterator. But remember, if you are not using these features, you are not recommended to use that. Okay, better you use the simple for each loop or the simply iterator. All right, this is about iterator. Okay, then comes to map. Okay, so map is not an iterative class of a collection, okay, which again it is also used for storing data, but it's a kind of dictionary kind of thing. Okay, so any map is an object that store association between two elements, that is a key and value. So association pair, key value pair, we say. Okay, so both keys and values are objects here. All right, we can store a key can be an object, and value also can be an object. Not necessarily key has to be an a key value type, a primitive type. Nothing is primitive type. Okay, and key must be unique. Values can be duplicated, but key has to be unique. Remember that. Okay, the every object that you pass an object, a key should be unique. And some map can access null key, null values, but other can. So there are variation of map, lot the number of variation of the map. Well, I will only focus on the hash map. Okay, which is quite efficient compared to other maps. Okay, and they don't implement iterative interface because map is a dictionary kind of data structure. So they does not, they, you cannot iterate over that. But okay, we can obtain a collection view of the map. Okay, which does by allowing, okay, using a using either a for loop or an iterator. Okay, so we can just have a, you know, on a collection view. Okay, we can iterate that. We'll see that how we can obtain that collection view. All right. So we have to first convert the map into a collection view, then we can iterate over that. All right. So map interface, okay, object can be created like this. So this is the syntax of that. All right. And K is the type of key and V is the type of value. Okay. This is the type, they are indicating the type. This is how we define it. Okay. Now some basic methods for adding element, put, and to access an element via key, the get object. Okay, get pass the key value. See, remember here in object type, that's why we are giving the object, object is the highest level. Okay, so object type. All right, so here put means we have to put the key value as well as the key value and as well as the value associated with the key. All right, so this is how. So remember, put an entry, okay, is invoked to the map overwriting the previous value associated with. Suppose there is already a value stored with the same key, that will be overwritten by the value you are passing right here. Okay, and if returns null if key did not already exist. Okay, if key is not there, otherwise your previous value will be linked to the key is written. All right, then same case, get case also, if the key is not found, then definitely you will get an error. Okay, and returns null. If you not actually null, you return the null value if your key is not found. All right. Now we can obtain a collection view by using the method entry set. Okay, because we cannot iterate over the map object, so we can get a collection view by using this method. So and over that we can use key set and values. Okay, method to obtain the key, obtain the obtain the values. Okay, so I for iteration purpose, let me tell you. Okay, because we want to see all the elements present in the map, so that can be done by these things. Okay, let us see. Okay, we'll see an example of that. So hash map, what is the benefit of hash map? It extend abstract map and implement the map interface. Okay, it combine the both of that. Okay, so abstract map is the higher level of map class. Okay, where all the map classes are extended. Now here, what is the advantage? That it uses a hash table to store the map. It's not store the element directly. It uses a hash table. Okay, that is the benefit. So it is quicker, and execution time for get and put is remain constant for any large set. Okay, so actually the performance doesn't decrease. That is the benefit of using hash map practically. Okay, so we declare hash map similar to the map. Everything is similar. Okay, you can see there are four type of constructors supported. One by passing a map, one empty hash map, then by capacity we give the how many elements will be there, and capacity and the fill ratio. I never use this the fourth one. So we can create the hash map in this way. We'll see some example of that hash map. Okay, so here is an example of hash map. Okay, so what is the hash map we create? So hash map is a generic class. So since it is a generic class, we have to pass the type of the elements. So what is it is always key value pair. So first part, so what is the key type? String. Here our key will be a string type. What is the value pair type? Double type. Okay, so hash map string double indicate that all the element will be in the pair format of a string and a double value. All right, so the object name is hm, and we're creating by using new operator, we are creating an empty hash map here. Then using put, we are adding the element hm put first string. This is the key. Jundo is the key, and new double. Okay, we are, because we cannot pass the double value. If you pass simply constant, it will be treated as a primitive type double, you know that by default, but it doesn't take any any primitive type here. So we simply create an object of new double. Okay, and pass it new double. That's why we are calling new double here. All right, double class, double type wrapper. Again, that the you can see the benefit of using type wrapper, learning type wrapper. Okay, so using type wrapper class, we are creating double object and passing it. Okay, so how many elements, how many key value pairs? 1 2 3 4 5 key value pairs are stored here. Now coming to the iteration, we cannot iterate over the object hm, but we can create a collection view. How we can create a by collection view is a set type. Remember that set, we can write map entry. Okay, so map entry, map dot entry. Okay, map dot entry, what is the entry type here? We have to give the what the map structure is, string and double. Okay, so the object is set, and that is equal to, we can call, how we can obtain collection view? By calling the method entry set. Okay, so hm dot entry set will give you the collection view, and that is stored in the collection manager set kind of thing. Okay, so that's why we're calling set generic set type. Okay, so using this set, now we can iterate over it. Okay, so for, you can see that for a map entry of type key value pair type string and double. Okay, which iterate over the the collection view set. Okay, the collection view set, we can print the value get key. As I told you, get key, get value method. We can use the get key, get value method over the collection view to get the values. Okay, so remember this whenever you want to iterate. If you not want to iterate, not a problem at all. Okay, then modify. Okay, so we can get get here, you can see that get method to obtain the value. All right, get, pass the key, get the value. The value will be the value will be a double type, double text wrapper type, but using assignment we have seen that automatic conversion to the primitive type is handled by the Java, so there won't be any problem here at this point. No problem, because auto conversion happens. Okay, but a little bit you have to careful when you are handling the object of this type. Okay, you cannot directly directly assign any primitive type. Whenever the type is required, a double type is required, you have to mention that, especially for the methods. Remember that for assignment it will work, as we have seen that auto boxing, auto unboxing can be done at the assignment level, but when you are passing here we should, if you will try to pass a double here, okay, then it will be a problem. If there is an integer, then if you pass a direct integer, there will be a problem. Okay, so you have to avoid the primitive types here, only the object types, okay, or the class types, right? Then we print the new balance here. Okay, after modification, we by using the get method will access the balance, the value, okay, value part of the John Doe. So whatever update has been done will be represented here. Let us see this demo. So hash map demo. So first, so you see that there is no order. Whenever we can add, there will be never be any order of. So it depends upon how they store, because they are not iteratable. They are not indexed. Okay, so they are stored in the form of key value pair. All right. So this is a hash map. Okay. So Todd Hall, then you see the John Doe, because but we have entered the data in a different order. You can see that. Let me show the program here. Okay, so we have added first John Doe, then Tom, then Becker, then Todd. But when you display, okay, using the collection view, it is some different. Okay, so not necessarily. So this is the order it is been printing on it. So then what we did? We using the get operation. Okay, we have modified the balance. Get and here get and put. Okay, first we get the value, then we put the value by updating it. We are adding a 1000 to this. So we added 1000 to this, and now you can see the new balance here. So be remember, for any map class, okay, the get and put method are generally to get the value using a key value or key, or put value to add a new key value pair into the map. Okay, these two methods are commonly used, and other method, essential methods, you can explore and learn and use as per your requirement. Okay, so with this, my small discussion on various collection classes is come to the end. And yeah, definitely you may need other you may need to know about other classes, other Java utility collection classes or interfaces. Please refer, especially like the list. You already have know these terms like list, array, you can say the simply the link list, all this. There are many type of lists also there, just like map. Okay, there are other type of maps also there. Okay, so please go through them. Almost all similars are there, and see one example of all this kind. So thank you for listening to me.